Hello dear students, welcome to Konark classes. In this session we are going to solve few questions based on the principle of mathematical induction. The first two questions, as you see in this board, the first question is let Pn is that mathematical statement. It represents 2 power n less than 1 into 2 into 3 up to n. Then the smallest positive integer for which Pn is true is what? The positive integer starts with 1, okay? So let's see what is the value of, you know, what is P1, okay? So P1 stands for, you know, 2 to the power 1 less than, you know, 1, because we will take the only the first term, no? So 2 to the power 1 less than 1, that is not true. So that means what? That means that P1 is false. P1 is false. Now let's take, so it is not true for n equal to 1. Now let's take P2, okay? So dear students, so what is P2? P2 stands for 2 to the power 2 is less than 1 into 2. What is 2 to the power 2? Is 4. So that implies what? That implies that 4 is less than 1 into 2 is 2. That is not correct, na? 4 is not less than 2. So from here, what we can say? We can say that P2 is false. Okay. Now let's look into P3. Okay. So P3 is that 2 to the power 3 is less than 1 into 2 into 3. What is meant by, so this implies 2 to the power 3 is 8, 8 is less than 1 into 2 into 3, that is 6. That is also not true. So 8 is not less than 6. So this implies that P3 is false. Okay, so what we see, dear students, for n equal to 1, this mathematical statement is not true. For n equal to 2, this mathematical statement is not true. For n equal to 3, this mathematical statement is not true. Now let's look for, you know, P4, that is for n equal to 4. So what is P4 stands for? 2 to the power 4 is less than 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. Okay. So that implies what? 2 to the power 4 is equal to is 16, is less than 2 into 3 is 6, 6 into 4 is 24. Yes, 16 is less than 24. That means that P4 is true. So that implies P4 is true. That means 4 is the smallest positive integer for which this statement that Pn stands for 2 to the power n less than 1 into 2 into 3 up to n is true. So we get the correct option as the option D. Okay, dear students. So now let's proceed to the second question. So second question is that a student was asked to prove a statement Pn by induction. He proved that Pk plus 1 is true whenever Pk is true. For all k greater than 5 and k belongs to capital N, the set of all natural numbers. And also that P5 is true. So that means what, dear students? So we see that, so if we work on this particular question, okay, so that we see that P5 is true. P5 is true according to the statement, right? P5 is true, that we have written it here. And then that is that we can consider as the first statement. And second one is that Pk plus 1 is true. Pk plus 1 is true when Pk is assumed to be true. Assumed to be true for what? K greater than 5. So for K greater than 5 and k belongs to the set of natural numbers. Correct? So now, according to the principle of mathematical induction, we can say that Pn is true for all n greater than or equal to 5, isn't it? If you look into our first session in the principle of mathematical induction, you will find that I discussed this particular point. So that means what? That means that mathematical statement Pn or mathematical proposition, okay, is true for all n greater than or equal to 5 and n belongs to capital N, the set of all natural numbers. So out of these four options, we see that option C is correct. Okay, dear students, so now let's proceed to the next question. Third question is, if Pn, which stands for 2 into 4 to the power 2n plus 1 plus 3 power 3n plus 1 is divisible by lambda for n belongs to capital N, that is the set of natural number, is true. That means this statement is true. This mathematical statement Pn is true. Okay, then the value of lambda is what? I repeat once more, dear students. So what is the mathematical statement here? Pn, 2 into 4 to the power 2n plus 1 plus 3 power 3n plus 1 is divisible by lambda for all n belongs to capital N. That mathematical statement is true. Then the question is that then the value of lambda is what? Okay. Now from this one, so this is the mathematical statement, na, that Pn equal to 2 into 4 to the power 2n plus 1 plus 3 power 3n plus 1 is divisible by lambda for all n belongs to capital N. Now let us find for P1, means for n equal to 1, or I can write something like this, that for n equal to 1, what is the value of this expression? For n equal to 1, for n equal to 1, what is the value of this expression? That 2 into 4 to the power 2 into 1 plus 1, okay, plus 3 power 3 into 1 plus 1. That is equal to what? That is equal to 2 into 4 to the power 2 into 1, 2 plus 1, 4 to the power 3 plus 3 to the power 3 into 1, 3 plus 1 is 4. So let me take the assistance of my notebook to write down the value, because it is not required to spend time on calculating this value. So this value is we are getting is equal to 209. So one thing we can say, dear students, that okay, for n equal to 1, the value of this expression is actually 209. Now let us find the value of this expression for n equal to 2. So for n equal to 2, what we are going to get, dear students, is that the value of the expression becomes what? 2 into 4 to the power 2 into 2 plus 1 plus 3 to the power 3 into 2 plus 1. That is equal to what, dear students? So we get 2 into 4 to the power 5. 2 into 2 plus 1, that is 5, 4 to the power 5 plus 3 to the power 3 into 2, 6 plus 1 is 7. 3 to the power 7. So what is the value we are going to get it here, dear students? So if we compute this value, so this value you are going to get is that 4235. Okay. So now let us concentrate. For n equal to 1, the value of the expression is 209. And for n equal to 2, the value of the expression is 4235. Correct? So now, as it is divisible by lambda for all n belongs to capital N, so what will be the value of lambda? The value of lambda must be the highest common factor of 209 and 4235. Correct or not? So that is what we know from our previous classes, class 10 standard, you know about HCF. So what will be the value of lambda? Lambda should be the highest common factor of 209 and 4235. Okay, And if you find this one, so you will get the value of lambda is equal to 11. And dear students, the value of lambda is actually 11 here. Okay, fine. Now let's proceed to the next question, that is question number 4. So question number 3 we are done. Now let's look into question number 4. What is question number 4? If Pn, that mathematical statement, stands for 49 to the power n plus 16 to the power n plus k is divisible by 64 for n belongs to capital N. You see, that entire Pn, that mathematical statement, stop here. That is 49 to the power n plus 16 to the power n plus k is divisible by 64 for n belongs to capital N. That is Pn, the mathematical statement, is true. According to the question, this mathematical statement is true. Then the least negative integral value of k is what? That you need to find. Okay, so let's see how we can approach this question. Okay. So, dear students, for n equal to 1, so we are going to solve this particular question here, okay? For n equal to 1, what is the value of the expression? For n equal to 1, what is the value of the expression? The value of the expression is 49 to the power 1 plus 16 to the power 1 plus k, okay? So that is equal to what? That is equal to 65 plus k. Now according to the question, that mathematical statement is that for n equal to 1, that p1 is divisible by 64. Now p1 is divisible by 64 means what, dear students? P1. So p1 stands for what? That 65 plus k is divisible by 64, is divisible by 64. Now how it is possible? It is possible when the value of k is equal to minus 1. So that 65, when you apply that k is equal to minus 1, then what is the value of the expression 65k plus k? That is 65 minus 1, that is equal to 64. Obviously 64 is divisible by 64. So k equal to minus 1 is the least negative integral value of k. Okay, so that this statement is true. So what we get, dear students? So we get the value of k as minus 1. Okay, so we are done with the fourth question as well. Now let's look into the fifth question. Okay, dear students, so let's look into the fifth question. That here we need to prove Pn, that is the mathematical statement or mathematical proposition, the way you want to say, is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to n square is equal to n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6 for n belongs to capital N, the set of natural numbers. That we actually know from our knowledge in sequence and series, that sum of the squares of the first n natural numbers is, n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6. And what we are going to do it here, dear students? So I am going to show you that how to solve this particular mathematical statement using the principle of mathematical induction. Okay, so we have done this type of questions earlier, okay, in our previous sessions, but let us do one more of this kind of question, and you see the steps to be followed. That is very important. The what is the first step we need to follow is that P1 is true. Okay, for n equal to 1, let me use a different color. Okay, so for n equal to 1, for n equal to 1, okay, what is the left hand side of P1? Left hand side of P1 is equal to 1 square, is equal to 1 square. The value of 1 square is 1. And what is the right hand side of P1? RHS of P1, that is equal to 1 into, what we can write, dear students? So 1 into 1 plus 1 into 2 into 1 plus 1 divided by 6. So that is equal to what? 1 into 1 plus 1 is 2 into 2 plus 1 is 3 divided by 6, and that is equal to 1. Correct or not? In the numerator 2 into 3, that is 6, denominator 6, 6 by 6 is 1. So what we see, dear students, for n equal to 1, the left hand side of P1 is equal to the right hand side of P1. That means what? P1 is true. So that is the first step we should do. So that implies that P1 is true. Okay. Now what is the next step we need to do? That we will assume that PK be true. For k greater than equal to 2 and k belongs to capital N, the set of natural numbers. So what you should do here, dear students, for that we will write here, let PK be true. Okay. Let me write it here. So let PK be true for k greater than equal to 2 and k belongs to capital N, the set of natural numbers. That means what? The moment we assume that PK be true, that means 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus dot 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 up to plus k square is equal to k into k plus 1 into 2k plus 1 divided by 6. We just applied, instead of n, we apply k. So that we have assumed to be true. That means in our proof, what about the steps we are going to follow now, we will assume that this is true. So in fact, we can give this as, you know, identity 1. Now what we need to prove? We need to prove that pk plus 1 is true. Now what is pk plus 1, dear students? So pk plus 1 is nothing but 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus dot 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 k square, and then k plus 1 is square, k plus 1 complete whole square. Okay, that should be equal to, if we write here, instead of n, we should write k plus 1. So n should be k plus 1, correct? Then n plus 1 should be what? K plus 1 plus 1, that is k plus 2. K plus 2. Then 2 into n plus 1, that means 2 into k plus 1 plus 1. So we can write his is that 2 into k plus 1 plus 1 divided by 6. Correct? In fact, we can simplify this thing. That's 2 into k plus 1 means what? 2k plus 2 plus 1, that is 2k plus 3. So instead of 2 into k plus 1 plus 1, we can directly write 2k plus 3. Correct, dear students? So we can write here 2 into k plus 3. Correct. So we need to prove that the value of that pk plus 1 in the left hand side is equal to this. So very important statement, dear students. Okay. So let me tell you that how to proceed. So let's first, you know, write what is LHS of pk plus 1. LHS of pk plus 1, this is equal to 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus dot 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 plus k square plus k plus 1 complete whole square. Now what we need to prove? We need to prove this is equal to this. That is our target. Okay, with the help of this one, that identity 1. So that means what? What we can write here, dear students? That instead of 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to k square, we can write k into k plus 1 into 2k plus 1 by 6. So we can write k into k plus 1 into 2k plus 1 divided by 6 plus के प्लस वन होल स्क्वायर. नाउ लेट अस टेक ए पॉज एंड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज अवर टारगेट. Our target is to find the value of this expression is this one. So in back of your mind, you should be thinking about, okay, whatever it is, I need to find the value of this expression as this. That should be your target. I repeat, dear students, that the value of this entire expression, as you see, this expression, okay? So the value of this expression should be this. That should be our target, okay? Now how we can achieve that? Let's see. So this is equal to what, dear students? So we can take k plus 1 common, okay? So we can take k plus 1 common. The moment we take k plus 1 common, dear students, so what we get? We get k into 2k plus 1 divided by 6 plus k plus 1, correct? So now let's simplify. So if we simplify, then what we are going to get it here? So let's do it here only. So that is equal to k plus 1, okay? So what we get is that, you know, LCM as 6 in the denominator, and we get it here 2 into k square plus k plus 6 into k plus 1, that is 6k plus 6. Correct? So second bracket is not required, first bracket is sufficient. Correct, no? So what we get it here, dear students? So that is equal to k plus 1 in the numerator, k plus 1 into 2k square plus 7k plus 6 divided by 6. I repeat once more, our target is to find this expression like this. So that means k plus 1 by 6 is already we have achieved. Now 2k square plus 7k plus 6, we need to perform middle term factorization so that we can express like k plus 2 into 2k plus 3. And that is quite obvious. This is equal to what, dear students? So let's take k plus 1 by 6 in one side. In one side means together. And 2k square plus 7k plus 6. So that we can write 2k square plus 4k plus 3k plus 6, middle term factorization, dear students. So then what you are going to get it here, dear students? So that is equal to k plus 1 divided by 6, okay? So here we get, from the first two terms, we can take 2k common. Then what we get? It is k plus 2. And from the next two terms, we can take 3 common. So what we get? K plus 2. So now what we get finally, dear students? So we get k plus 1 divided by 6 into, from these two we can take, from these two expressions we can take k plus 2 common. If we take k plus 2 common, then we left with 2k plus 3. So we get 2k plus 3. So dear students, so what we get? We get that is equal to, this value is equal to k plus 1 into k plus 2 into 2k plus 3 divided by 6. And we are able to achieve this one, exactly the same value. So that is equal to what? RHS of PK plus 1, RHS of PK plus 1. So dear students, what we see? That left hand side of PK plus 1 is equal to the right hand side of PK plus 1. That left hand side of PK plus 1, what we have started with, we see that is equal to the right hand side of PK plus 1. So that means what? That means PK plus 1 is true. So what we can write? So PK plus 1 is true. So that implies that PN is true. PN is true for N belongs to capital N, the set of all natural numbers. So these are the steps to be followed. First, you need to prove that P1 is true. Then you assume that PK be true for K greater than equal to 2 and K belongs to the set of natural numbers. Now with that assumption, prove that PK plus 1 is true. Once you are done, then you can say with full confidence that PN is true for all natural numbers N, as it is mentioned here. So dear students, so with this, let me conclude the session here. Now what you need to do, you need to perform the daily practice problem as available in the online platform at konarkclasses.com, followed by you need to perform practice test, followed by you need to give unit test, followed by you need to give module test, and finally you need to give the mock test. These are the phased manner you need to give test, so that will giving you a great amount of confidence. So with this note, let me conclude the session here. Thank you very much. Bye.